Good morning, class. In continuation of what we have been doing as correction to the question I gave you during the past days, I have solved some already. I think I've solved number one, number three, and number five. This one is number six, number seven, and number eight. Let me start with the number six question. Number six question says, use a ruler and a compasses to construct the hexagon. Construct hexagon that is inscribed in a circle. So we are going to use a ruler and compass to construct hexagon that is inscribed in a circle. Before we go there, you should know what an hexagon is. An hexagon is a six-sided shape. So all it means is that we're going to construct a six-sided shape in this circle. How do we go about it? Now, this is the circle that was given. This is why you need your rule. First thing you do is to mark the center of the circle. Mark the center. Note, that's what I mean. Note the center. Let's assume here is the center. Center is somewhere here. Mark the center. Use your rule to create a radius or a diameter, whichever you want. So noting the center, this has been here is the center. Note the center. Now, after getting this, measure out the radius or mark the value of the radius with your compass. The radius should be from here to here, that's from the middle to this place. That's the radius. From the middle to this place. Now, note your compass very well. Place it at one end of where the length of line that you have created. Mark a point there. Place this one here, like that, mark another point, or cut another arc. Place this one here, that's the arc. Here also, you cut another arc. Then here, cut another arc. After doing this, you are done. The next thing is to join all this arc with a straight line using your ruler, starting from this first place. Mark this point, that's the beginning. That's one. Mark the other point. That's two. And here's the third one. Mark this point. That's three. Here's the fourth one. Four. Here's the fifth one. And lastly, here's the sixth one. If you count the number of sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, number of sides in the shape I just created now is 6. And a 6-sided figure is called what? An hexagon. That is the hexagon. This is the hexagon. An hexagon. So I've succeeded in inscribing the hexagon in a circle. This is how it's done. It's as simple as this. Then the number 7 question says, draw. The diagram show a triangle and they ask us to bisect the triangle. Bisect PR, that was the first thing. Remember, we said bisect means to divide a line. And how do you divide a line? Place one end here. Place one end here. Make an arc up and down. Don't bother about the construction mark.
just creates an arc. Place the other end here. Use the first arc to cut the second one like that. So I succeeded in doing this. Then the next thing you do is to join the point using a rule like this. Use a rule, join the point. After doing that, they said we should also bisect another part in the triangle. I can decide to bisect this side, can decide to bisect this side. Any side will do. If I'm to bisect this side, this is what you have. Place this end here, make a cut up and down like that. Place this one here also, make a cut up and down like that. At the end, you have two lines meeting at this point. You meet at this point, that's the segment of the point, that's the point, second point here. You meet at that point, then you draw a line, that's the line that bisects it. So, and the third question says the intersection of the two lines form a circle. Meaning, if here is the intersection of the first two lines, the lines that result with a bisection of the sides, place the point end of the compass here and place it here like this. Make a circle like that. Using that, using this point, we make a circle. When you look at my circle, the triangle is now inscribed inside the circle. This is how or what you are supposed to do, something like this. First thing first, draw the triangle, after which bisect the first part, then bisect any of the part, this other side, this or this, they will meet at this point. Then use this as the center of the circle. Get the radius from here to here, use it to form a circle. That's how it's done. Then lastly, the number 8 question says we should draw a perpendicular that will run through this point. Draw a perpendicular. A perpendicular line is a line that is at 90 degrees to a horizontal line. So how do we make a perpendicular line? They are giving us the point that the line must run through. Take that point as the center. Use your compass. Put it to any radius like this. Make a point here, here, like that. After making a point, then use this also as center. Make another point. Open up your radius. Open up your radius. Make another point like this. Without changing the radius, place this one here. Make another point. Then at the end, use your rule to draw a line that will run through the three points, the two points. So this one now is perpendicular to this. That is how you do or draw a perpendicular line.